Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So this is my website where you can find all the video links related to Salesforce. Those are created by me. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate you how we can use after insert, after update, and after delete together in Apex Trigger. So let's understand the scenario that we are going to use. So common scenario is there, like if opportunity is created and if amount is not null, then we need to add amount to accounts annual revenue field. So this is on insert. Then if we are updating any opportunity and we are updating the amount, so that needs to be updated to accounts annual revenue too. And if we are deleting any opportunity, so we need to update the annual revenue accordingly. Because if opportunity is deleted, so that amount should be deducted from the annual revenue, right? So to implement this scenario, let's see this. So this is account record, and on account we have this annual revenue field, and we need to sum up all the related opportunities amount, right? So for this, I already created trigger. So I created trigger on opportunity because this should be performed on creation, updation, and deletion of opportunity. So after insert, after update, and after delete events are available here. Then these are context variable. So if a trigger dot is after is true, then if is insert is true, so this on after insert method will be called. So I have created separate handler class for this trigger, that is opportunity trigger handler. So on creation, we have a new list. So that is available in trigger.new. So I'm passing it in this method. On update, we have new as well as old map. So I'm passing both the parameters. And in case of delete, we have trigger.old. Now, if I move to opportunity trigger handler, so here you can see all three methods are available. So now we need to apply the logic. So first I'm going to apply the logic for after insert. So here, let's say I'm going to create a set of ID, account IDs, then list of So this I am creating. Now I'm going to iterate this new list. So for opportunity, so now I need to identify the account ID through these new inserted opportunities, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add account ID through this way, right? So whatever opportunity you are creating, so if it is related to any account, so we need to put the account ID. So we can apply one if condition as well. So if OPP dot account ID not equals to null, then only it will be added. So there may be possibilities, like if you are inserting any opportunity and that is not linked to any account, so that will generate an error, right? So this way I created this set, and after completion of this loop, I'm going to call a common method that will be used for insert, update, and delete for all. So calculate annual revenue, and I'm passing this ACC ID set to this method, right? And whenever this account to be updated list will be returned, so I'm going to check if is this list dot is empty. So if it is not empty, then update, right? So it is showing some errors. So let's check the errors. Okay. Forgot to write new. So this way you saw I created one set of IDs. So this set will be storing account IDs. Those are related to opportunities. Then I created a list of account that we are going to update. Then opportunities are iterated. So if OPP dot account ID is not equals to null, so account ID, right? So if on opportunity account ID is not null, then that account ID will be available in this set. We are passing this set to this method so that we can calculate annual revenue, and the updated list will be passed here, and that will be processed. Okay, so why this error is coming? Because this method is right now not available. So let me create a block only. So list of account, method name, set of ID, account IDs. So this method we are going to define later on. So first let me copy this. Yeah, I'm pasting it here. So this is for on after update. So new list and old map both are available. So I'm iterating new list. So if account ID is not null, and now we need to check one more thing, whether the amount that is available on opportunity that is updated or not, right? So what I can do, OPP dot amount not equals to old map dot get OPP dot ID dot amount, right? So if new list amount that we are accessing through OPP dot amount is not equals to old map, so old version amount and new version amount, if both are not matching, in that case the related account ID will be available in this set. And we're passing this into this method, then same operation will be available here, right? And now we need to perform this for deletion. So let me implement that as well. So I'm pasting it again. So here we have old list. So I'm going to iterate this old list, and yeah, rest of the things will be same. If account ID is not null, then we need to put that account ID into this set, and then we need to call this method. So this way I implemented all three methods, right? So they are finding the account related account IDs, and through that we need to now calculate annual revenue. So now I'm going to implement this method. So this will be the account list. In that we will be storing the data that we are going to update. Now I'm going to create a map of ID comma decimal. So account ID to annual revenue. So this is a map. So after this, now what I'm going to do, now I'm going to query all the related opportunities with the account ID that we fetched here, so that we can calculate the annual revenue. So I'm iterating for opportunity OPP, then I'm writing SOQL, so select ID, comma amount from opportunity where account ID and ACC IDs, right? So this way all those opportunities will be queried where account ID is available in this set, right? Now we will be iterating all the fetched opportunities, and then we need to return this one. So I'm writing this as well, return. So we need to finally return this one, right? And here we need to implement the logic. So now all the opportunities will be available into this OPP. So one by one, we need to iterate and we need to calculate the annual revenue. So here I'm creating one more variable, decimal total equals to zero. Now if, so we have this map. So we need to use map name dot, not get, let's say contains key. And key will be OPP dot account ID, right? So if this map is containing the account ID, it means that account is already available in that map. So what we can do, we can put total equals to this map dot get OPP dot account ID, right? So if opportunities related account ID is already available in this map, so it's that map's value will be available into this total, right? And further what we can do, so further we need to calculate total equals to total plus and the amount that is available on opportunity, so OPP dot amount, right? So first time whenever opportunity will be available, so the account ID won't be available in this map. So total will be zero. So zero will be added to this opportunity amount, right? So what we can do, one more thing. We can apply if OPP dot amount is not equals to null. In that case only this total will be calculated. So this also you can do. So null pointer exception can be resolved. Now we have total value. So what we are going to do, we need to put this in this map. So first time this if won't be executed. So total will be zero. So zero will be added to this opportunity amount and that will be stored in this, right? So dot put OPP dot account ID comma total. Okay, so here you can see some errors are available. So the spelling was incorrect. So I need to write account ID. So that was misplaced and more errors are coming, like a non-static method cannot be referenced from a static context. So yeah, public static. So now those errors will be resolved. So now what you see, this map will be having account ID and the total after completion of this loop. So now we need to iterate this map. So checking if it is having some values or not. So if this map is not empty, then we can iterate this map. So for ID equals to ID, let's say I, and the map name dot key set. Now account ACC equals to new account, then ACC dot ID equals to I, and ACC dot annual revenue equals to, now we need to use the map dot get I. So in map, on this key, whatever value is available, that will go to this ACC, that instance that we created, and we need to put this into the map. So here is the map, sorry, list. Into this list, we need to add this ACC, right? And after completion of this loop, this list will be returned to the above methods. So on top, you can see while inserting, we use this list. So after calculation, this method will be returning a list. So that will be checked if it is not empty. So accounts will be updated. And similarly for this after update, and similarly for after delete. And this is a common method for all three. So here we have an error. Okay, this should be account ID. So I'm mistakenly typing D instead of T. So API ID should be correct, otherwise errors will be there. So now it is complete. So I'm saving this. This is already saved. Now moving to account. So let's check the related. Okay. So it is having one opportunity already. And if I open this opportunity, and if I check the details, so here you can see amount is blank. Okay. So let me use this account ID. I'm using this account ID and I'm going to use this anonymous window to create opportunities, to create, update and delete, so that we can apply this on bulk as well. So what I'm going to do, opportunity OPP1 equals to new opportunity, then OPP1 dot name equals to test1, OPP dot stage name equals to prospecting. Let's check the stages as well. Yeah, it is prospecting, and OPP dot close date equals to system dot today, right? And OPP dot account ID equals to, so I'm copying this. So for testing purpose, I am hard coding this. So this is first opportunity. I'm copying this, creating one more, right? And opportunity. So now I'm going to create a list so that we can perform bulk operation. So opportunity, list of opportunity, OPP list equals to new list of opportunity, right? So now in this, I'm going to add these OPP1, OPP2, and insert OPP list, right? So right now you can see amount is also not there. So let's put that as well. Amount equals to 1000 and OPP dot amount equals to 2000. One more mistake I did. I used OPP instead of OPP1 and here OPP instead of OPP2. Okay, now everything is ready. So I can execute these, right? Don't want to open the log, so I'm executing. Okay, so this is showing an error. Okay, so what is the error? It is saying I queried SOQL without querying account ID because I'm using that here, right? So I need to use account ID here as well. So whatever field we use in process, so we need to query that as well. So now if I execute this, so it will be executed successfully. I am doing a refresh. So you will see two more opportunities will be related to this account. So let's check the related list. So here you can see total three opportunities are available. So here amount is 2000 and here amount is 1000 and earlier one was zero, right? And we also applied null check. So let's check the details. So here you can see annual revenue is 3000, right? Now let me update these. So I'm updating this one to 5000, right? So now total should be 7000. So update. Okay, let me update both. So update OBP list, execute. Okay, it is saying ID not provided. So for updation, we need to provide the ID as well. Okay, so OPP1.ID equals to, so here one opportunity ID I need to provide that I'm going to update. So these are the things that we need to remember whenever we want to perform any operation. So I'm fetching this, putting it here. Now I'm opening another one, copying its ID. Here as well. So I'm now executing. So now it executed successfully. So what was the values? 3000, 5000. So now let's check. So I'm refreshing. So opportunity amount will also be updated and the annual revenue on account will also be updated. So here you can see annual revenue is 8000. And on the related opportunity, you can see 5000 and 3000 is there. So in case of updation also it is working fine. Now it's time to delete. So let's say delete OPP1. I'm just deleting one opportunity. So I just want to execute this. Okay, for that, let me query this opportunity for deletion here. So select ID. Opportunity where ID equals to, let's say this one, and delete OPP. So these two statements I'm going to execute. So what I need to do, I need to click on this execute highlighted. By mistake, I was clicking on execute. So I'm clicking on execute highlighted. So now it is deleted. So if we click on execute, so all the statements are executed. So this also we need to remember. So now I did a refresh on account. So you will see one opportunity is deleted and annual revenue is updated. So it is now 5000 and total two opportunities are available. So this way, I hope you understood all three operations after insert, after update, and after delete. So you can implement this code in your org as well. So initial, after insert, after update, and after delete code are somehow similar. And they are using this common method so that we can calculate total amount on annual revenue field that is available on account. So implement this in your org so that you can understand the process. So if you want to watch more Salesforce related videos, so you can go to this website and you can find video links. Those are created by me. Thank you for watching this video.